Okay, now we are on MEC. If you'd like to close, feel free to do that. Right, we'll begin. Recording as well.
Recording in progress. Good morning, everyone. If CM Alice is not here, perhaps CM Jatwin, you can start.
Hello. So can you hear me well?
Yes, we can.
Yes. Thank you very much. I'm very thank you for this opportunity. First of all, I'd like to thank to organizer Burmese American Community Institute and MoEEC for organizing this event. I'd like to thank Professor David Williams for providing this public lecture with us today. For those of you who don't know Professor David Williams, Professor Williams has been supporting federal democracy struggle in Myanmar for many years through his scholarship and with his high spirit. So in this revolution, many people have come to understand the problems this country is facing. It's deeply rooted in the influence of prolonged dictatorship and sidelining any conversation about federalism. So now people have come to realize federalism is the way for our country, the way forward for our country, and an antidote to the military dictatorship and political manipulation. For the NUG as a government, its duty include adopting and implementing the strategy of eradication of dictatorship, abolishment of 2008 constitution, and building of federal democracy union. So in this spirit, I believe one thing we can do as a citizen, as individual who wants a better future for Myanmar is to educate ourselves about federalism. The Ministry of Education is honored to lend a platform to discuss about federalism like this public lecture. We are also very honored to have Professor William giving us a lecture for a second time. The first lecture was received really well among the listener, and it was received really well among ones who are very keen to learn about, who are new to federalism concept and who are very keen to learn about it. So thank you very much for Professor Williams for your contribution. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that introduction. I would also like to recognize my colleague, Liz Adams, the Associate Director of the CCD. I'm hoping there will be lots of questions today and she'll be moderating the questions. So if you can send them to the chat function, she'll be keeping track. Amy? I would also like to thank Ami, who just spoke, who will do the serial translation today. It's not easy to do this because what I'm about to talk about a lot of technical words and some concepts, but Ami has been a wonderful student here, a great blessing to me, and I'm looking forward to working with her for many years.
Okay, yes, Professor. Yeah, go ahead.
Right, all right, very good. So I'm gonna hopefully share my screen.
Do not need it, and the screen will share on me.
There we go, all right. Now, last time we talked about federalism and democracy, and of course, this is an enormously important question, and everybody has a view. Today, we're going to talk about an equally important question, and that's federalism and ethnicity, especially ethnic conflict in Myanmar. And again, in Myanmar, people have been talking about this subject. They have been arguing about this subject for many years, at least since 1947, and really even before. And again, everybody has a view. So I hope that there will be lots of comments and questions when I am done speaking. Now, part of the difficulty is that the Tamada has been spreading a lot of misinformation about federalism. So a lot of what I want to do today is just clear up that confusion to talk about what federalism does and more especially what it does not do. Okay, now, it turns out this subject is so important, we decided to split it into two lectures. And so I'll deliver the first part now and the second part at the next lecture. In part one, my theme today is that federalism is good for everyone, not just for the ethnic nationalities. Now, as Sayama Jotoypen just indicated, of course, the Tamada, in a sense, have taught this to us, right? That we all now can benefit from federalism because the coup teaches us the dangers of centralization, of locking up all of the power in just a small number of people. And then in the next lecture, what I want to suggest is that federalism can actually help reduce ethnic conflict. In many ways, it is the solution to ethnic conflict. And I stress that because, of course, the Tamada has suggested in times past that federalism actually makes ethnic conflict worse. And that is generally not the case. Now, I would also like to note that there are two happy events right now, happy conditions for giving this lecture. The first is that 20 years ago, the Tamada took the view, and many people believe this, that federalism would bring disastrous consequences and a breakup of the union. And very few people, I think, now believe that. So there's a remarkable openness to talking about federalism that was not as present 20 years ago. The second thing that I would like to notice is that I'm especially grateful to the NUG for inviting me to give this lecture, because federalism involves pushing power closer to the people. And that means, to some extent, taking power from the central government. And it's really unusual when you get a central government who wants to think about how to give away some of their power. But truthfully, that's the key to a happy future. when the central government really wants to say to the people, here, take power back into your hands. Now, before we get technical, let me start with some very basic observations. The first is, when we look at politics around the world, there are two basic kinds of people in the world. The first kind, they want to concentrate power in a small number of people. And we can call these centralizers. And the second group are those who want to deconcentrate power, to push power closer to the people so that more and more of the people have a chance to influence the government. We can call these federalists. Now, federalism, as we'll see in a minute, involves spreading power around to a lot of different groups of people. Now, we might also say the same is true for democracy, that what that really does is spread power around to a lot of people. And the same is also true for individual rights. So that a great deal of what constitutions do is they try to make sure that power is not locked up in a small group of people, but instead is spread broadly. So more and more people have some kind of self-determination and self-government.
So Diluniama, the federal sinecono below low level, the possible chicken ma the set the look banquet anari ha lunesu lute chosen ma besi piro shini ram hope in it.
Now, in a very real sense, the central struggle of the world today is between centralizers and federalists, those who want to concentrate power and those who want to deconcentrate power. Now, we know who the Tatmadaw is. The Tatmadaw, they're centralizers. And so, of course, the question we need to ask is, which of these do we want to be?
So the lashi kabama so in the Bhu Wadi the Mari ne the federal wadi the chare malu apja in lo swemu chip bares so lu apja in lo swemu chi the chua the through look and with anario who domam hope the niare ma lunesu mabe susi don't chine the Japan Majaro the Anna Kwewi Pancha Chin Dong Chingo the Lulu Lala net chin don't chinjane.
Now the reason I stress this is that in the past, the Tatmadaw has tried to tell us that the disagreement over federalism is between Burman people and non-Burman people, because federalism is good for non-Burman people, but bad for Burman people. But what I want to suggest is that's not true. The real disagreement is between the centralizers and the federalists. And it's not about, therefore, ethnicity. It's about whether you want to concentrate power.
ဒီအဖက်ဒရယ်နဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ပြောလို့ရှိရင်အကဒီအဒီပမာလူမျိုးနဲ့ပမာမဟုတ်တဲ့အခြားသောလူမျိုးစုတွေခြားထဲမှာဖြစ်တဲ့ဒီအပြိုင်လွန်ဆွဲမှုတမမဟုတ်လို့ရှိရင်ဒီအာဏာနဲ့အာဏာလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာခွဲဝေပိုင်ခြားမှုနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ဒီလိုမျိုးရှုနေမှာလေဒါမဲ့အမှန်တကယ်ကတော့ဒီဘဟုဝါဒီတမားတွေနဲ့ဒီ
Let me offer a personal observation. I have spent most of my life working towards federalism in a number of different places and thinking about it. And here I think is the key distinction, that at the heart of federalism, at the center of federalism, is the idea that local communities are precious, and when possible, ordinary people should be given the chance to solve their own problems in their own way. And the key quality then to federalism is actually love. It's the love of local people trying to build up a solution to their lives in their own way.
So
that's the hope that is given to us by federalism, that it will be about love through deconcentration. Here is the fear. The fear is that central planners in the central government don't really understand local communities and they don't really care about them. But these central planners believe they're really smart and should be running everything. And of course, this is exactly what the tap makes. And so the key quality here about centralization is the desire of some people to dominate other people.
So the federalism yet the two minute to change out the area, change out the area by less which the Poho Bani Birokajaro, the Ditandra Osuma Shire, a chinidi, a natario, gong gong dishi knowledge in Mishibu, a large bed, Poho Nine, Poho Suya Nine, the Diarigo,
Now, much of human life, especially in politics, is of course a struggle between love and domination, because humans are prone to both of these. Humans are prone to love other humans, but they're also prone to dominate other humans. And we have to decide which side we want to be on. And of course, in the end, the key thing is that love should win. And that's what federalism is about.
So, Raji,
Now, with that in mind, let's turn to the relationship between federalism and ethnicity. And the first thing we might ask is federalism only about ethnicity? Does it help only the ethnic nationalities? Well, the answer, as we've just suggested, is no. In fact, federalism helps everybody.
大家問我的federalism的理由是什麼呢?哎呀,我記沒說了,先,the federalism哈說了先,the理由是講清楚的,不會啦說了,好吧,比較看著,都哈的的理由是的,the前提的個關於上面的什麼啦說了,好吧,federalism哈說了先,要明白到的就是說的,你來
Now, federalism has at least six different benefits. It can bring six different good things to us. And I'm going to go through each of those in just a moment and suggest that all six will benefit everybody, Burman people and non-Burman people alike.
ဒီဖက်ဒရယ်စနစ်ကဒီအနည်းဆုံးဒီအကျိုးကျေးဇူးပြုတဲ့အချက်6ချက်ရှိပါတယ်ဒီ6ချက်ဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်လူမျိုးစုတစ်ခုချင်းစီလူမျိုးစုတွေကိုဖြစ်စေပမာလူမျိုးကိုဖြစ်စေဒီအကျိုးကျေးဇူးရှိပါတယ်ဒီပမာမဟုတ်လို့လူမျိုးတခြားလူမျိုးဖြစ်လို့အကျိုးကျေးဇူးမဖြစ်ဘူးဆိုတာမျိုးမဟုတ်ပါဘူးအားလုံးအတွက်အကျိုးကျေးဇူးရှိတဲ့ဖက်ဒရယ်စနစ်ဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဒါကိုကျွန်တော်တစ်ခ
So just so that we have a shared body of concepts. You will remember that the definition of a federal constitution is that it divides power between the union government and the states. And usually what does that is it gives power over certain subjects to the union, state affairs, national defense, and it gives power over other subjects to the states, such as agriculture and schools and social services.
ဒီဖက်ဒရယ်စနစ်ကဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဖက်ဒရယ်ကနေပေါက်ဖွာလာတဲ့ဖွဲ့စည်းပုံအခြေခံဥပဒေဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သူဟာဘဟုနဲ့ဘဟုအစိုးရနဲ့ပြည်နယ်အစိုးရဂျာမာအာဏာပိုင်းခြားခွဲဝေကျင့်သုံးတာဖြစ်ပါတယ်အလားတူပဲဒီပုံမှန်အနေနဲ့ကတော့သူဟာဒီတချို့သောအာဏာတွေကိုတချို့အကြောင်းအရာတွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အာဏာတွေကိုဘဟုပေးပြီးတော့ခါကြတော့တချို့အကြောင်းအရာနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်
subject matter, it is said that the government is competent over that subject matter. And so the power to control a certain subject matter is often called a competency in English. And what that means is a federal constitution divides competencies between the union and the states, and a division of competencies, therefore, is that division, the section of the constitution that gives some subject matters to the union and some to the states.
ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့အခုဒီလိုမျိုးဒီလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာကိုထိန်းချုပ်ပြီးတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီအကြောင်းရတစ်ခုချင်းစီပေါ်မှာလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာလေးခွဲဝေပေးခြင်းကိုဒီအာဏာခွဲဝေခြင်းလို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ခေါ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီ
Divisions of competencies are different in different countries and appropriately so. We need the one that is right for Burma. We can't just borrow one from another country. Now, by contrast to federalism, in a unitary government, the Constitution gives all of the power to the central government. It doesn't give any power to the states. And so the union government, the central government, can create local governments, but they're just a part of the union government. They're not a separate sovereign.
So la ka ja ro di pi dang su sin ne ma so lo shin yin lou pai khwe a na ri a long ga bo ho ma ba a long ga su si ba de so ro di a ya a long ga bo wa ni twan mo chou kai pi lo saung yet da phit ba de da chaung mo lo di pi ne di a ni ne di pi dang su de ma ba de so yin naw ma tru ha pi dang su ye a sait pai de khu phit ဖြစ်တော်ညာလေးပဲသူတို့ရဲ့တုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတွေအားလုံးအရာရာရဲ့အဆုံးဖြတ်ချက်ကပို့ပို့ကနေလာပါတယ
် Okay now in a federal system then the constitution guarantees power to the states so the union can't just take that power away the union is not above the states don't work for the union instead the union has its domain and the state has its domain and each is independent of the other
the federal စနစ်မှာဆိုရင်တော့ဒီဖွဲ့စည်းပုံအခြေခံဥပဒေဟာဒီနိုင်ငံရဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတွေအားလုံးကိုဒီသူ့အနေနဲ့သူပိုင်ချခွဲဝေပြီးတော့အနှင်းပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ပြည်နယ်အနေနဲ့သူ့မှာသူ့ရဲ့ဒီလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတတ်သက်ရှိပါတယ်ပြီးတော့အဲ့ဒီလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဘဟုကနေပြီးတော့ဒီတိမ့်ပိုက်တာမျိုးလှုပ်ဆောင်လှုပ်ယူသွားတာမျိုးလုပ်လို့မရပါဘူးဒါကြောင့်မလို့စံပြည်နယ်အနေနဲ့ပြည်နယ်အကန့်နဲ့အတူတကွသူ့မှာလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတည်ချရှိပြီးတော့ဘဟုအနေနဲ့လည်းသူ့အနေနဲ့သူတည်တဲ့လုပ်ကိုအနာရှိပါတယ်ဒီအရာတစ်ခုကဆိုလို့အတူတကွအလုပ်တာဖြစ်ပြီးတော့တစ်ဖက်နဲ့တစ်ဖက်ကိုလွှဲမိုးတာချဲ့နေတာကြီးဆိုးတာမျိုးမရှိပါဘူ
း Now as long as the states stay within their domain as long as they confine themselves to their subject matters they can do whatever they want and the union cannot interfere and that's what it means to say that the states are sovereigns in a federal system that with respect to their subject matters They're the sovereign. They can do what they want. And then the union, with respect to its subject matter, is also sovereign. So you have a kind of dual sovereignty here.
Okay. So the tilo ni thama tineri ini nega tu ye pai ne tu ye ne be twe ma tu ye anao chin tong ni tanya kala palonga di poho ini ne တီနေရဲ့လုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်ကိုဝေရဆွတ်ဖတ်နိုင်ခြင်းမရှိပါဘူးဆိုတော့အလားတူပဲဘ ഹു ရဲ့လုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အဆိုရင်လည်းပဲဒီပြည်နယ်အနေနဲ့တွားပြီးတော့လွှဲမှုချုပ်ကန်လုတ်ဆွတ်ဖတ်တာမျိုးမရှိပါဘူးဆိုတော့တနည်းအားဖြင့်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီချုပ်ချာအနာနှစ်ရက်ကအတူတကွတည်ရှိပြီးတော့မိတည်နေတာဖြစ်ပါတယ
် Now the Tatmadaw of course has told us over and over again that having two sovereigns is crazy, it's necessarily going to lead to civil war and all kinds of conflict. And so we should now pause for a minute and ask ourselves, well, why might we want the states to be independent sovereigns over certain subjects? Why might it be a good thing to have states as sovereigns? And that'll tell us why we have federalism.
ဒီကနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ဒီတမတော်ကအများရင်ပြောနေတာကဒီချုပ်ချာအာဏာနှစ်ရက်ဆိုတာမျိုးပေါ့နော်အဲ့ဒါမျိုးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အများရင်ရှုပ်ထွေးတယ်ပြဿနာဆောင်ကျင်းတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဒါပေမဲ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကဒါကိုပြင်ကြည့်မယ်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဘာလို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကဒီလိုမျိုးဒီလုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာနှစ်ရက်ကဒီမရှိရမဒီလုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာနှစ်ရက်ကအတူတကွာပေါ့နော်ဘာလို့အလုံးမလုံးနိုင်ရမှာလဲကျွန်တော်တို့ဒါကိုတခြားပိုင်ခြားစစ်စစ်ပြီးတော့ဘာလို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဒီလိုမျိုးကိုယ့်ရဲ့အချုပ်ချာအာဏာနဲ့ကိုလုတ်ဆောင်ကျင့်သုံးနိုင်မှုကိုဘာလို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဘက်ကမလုံးနိုင်ရမှာလဲဆိုတာကိုကြည့်ဖို့လိုပါတယ
် Now there are good reasons to give the union government power over certain subjects and there are other good reasons to give the state power over other subjectsAnd that's just because the union is good at doing some jobs, certain tasks, and the states are good at doing other tasks.
So, I mean, that boho ni ne tu ni ne patate lo pan khwin ni tu ni ne boho ye lo pan khwin ni ya pe bu lo at de a chang shi de lo da di lo boho ye lo pan khwin wo pe ya de a chang pya che kaung shi de lo be pi ne a ni ne le pi ne ne patate deကျောင်းချင်းရမှာသူ့ရဲ့ကိုယ်ပိုင်လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်ကိုပေးခြင်းဟာဒီကောင်းတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့ဒါကကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့ဒီတခုချင်းစီကိုလုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာပေးရတဲ့ကျောင်းကောင်းတော့အကြောင်းရဲ့အချက်လက်ကိုရှိတဲ့အကြောင်းကိုကျွန်တော်တို့သိဖို့လိုပါတယ
် Yeah the union government is good when what we really need is unity or uniformity And sometimes we really do need unity and uniformity. So we have to think about when that's the case, and then we'll assign those subjects to the union government. Now, just as an example, almost everybody thinks it's good for a country to have one currency. You don't want the states to issue their own currencies because it just will lead to confusion and difficulty. So it's good for the central government to decide our currency will be the chat. And that just helps everybody. It's not a bad thing.
ဆိုတော့ဒီဥပမာငွေကြေးသုံးဆွဲမှုပေါ့နော်ဒါဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီငွေကြေးကမြန်မာနိုင်ငံအနေနဲ့ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီငွေကြေးကမြန်မာနိုင်ငံအနေနဲ့ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အငွေကြေးသုံးဆွဲမှုအနေနဲ့တစ်ခုရှိတယ်ချက်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဒါကတနိုင်ငံလုံးအနေနဲ့ချက်တစ်ခုတည်းကိုပဲအားလုံးစုပေါင်းပြီးသုံးနေဆိုတာကအမှန်တကယ်လည်းအလုပ်ဖြစ်တဲ့အရာဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုတော့ဒီလိုမျိုးဆိုလို့ရှိရင
should do the same thing all the time. That in other words, we always need uniformity. And that's really not true. The reality is most of the time it's fine for people to do things differently. And so states are good when it's good for us to be diverse, to do things in different ways. The states are also good when it's really for the decision to be made as close to the people as possible. So diversity and closeness to the people, these are the things the states are good at.
So di jenaro di showcase ari ma di ya along di tutu nyi nyi po no ya along di pongsan to khu le ma ba tu su si bi twa ra myo le kha di cha yin ma lo up bu po no so ra kha cha ra upama di pi ne ri di di ma jenaro adika pya chin na ka pi ne ri ha so lo shin yin မတူကွဲပြားမှုတွေအမျိုးမျိုးနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့လောက်ကိုင်းဆောင်ရွက်ရတဲ့နေရာမှာသူ့အနေနဲ့ကပြည်သူတွေနဲ့လည်းပို့ပြီးတော့နှိစက်တဲ့အဆိုးရတရဖြစ်သလိုသူ့အနေနဲ့ဒါကိုကောင်းကောင်းနိုင်နိုင်နဲ့ကိုင်းတွင်နိုင်တာဖြစ်ပါတယ်။ဒါကြောင့်မလို့ဒီလိုအရာတွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်လို့ရှိရင်ပြည်နယ်ကအဲဒီလောက်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာကရှိတင်ပြီးတော့သူ့အနေနဲ့တရားအတွက်ဒီအာလောက်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာရှိဖို့လိုတယ်သူ့အနေနဲ့ဆွမ်းဆောင်ရည်ပြည့်ဝဖို့လည်းလိုပါတယ်။
Now, more particularly, what we then need to ask is, which jobs require diversity and or closeness to the people? So what subject matters require or suggest diversity and closeness? And there are six basic types of jobs, I believe, that require diversity and closeness.
Okay, so di bo ma di jenaro ya di matu kwe pya mu ri ga be be alauk di ma di matu kwe pya mu a che khan di lou ya da phit de le be be alauk di ma be chang ya ri ma ja ro di ni kat mu bo no ni ni kat kat lou saung mu ga lou at de le so da ko jenaro ti tu chi ja ya au bo no so ro di ya ne patat pi ro di a chang chin ya bo di alauk kai ne patat pi ro di 6
So I'm going to give you the full list now on this slide, but then of course what I'm going to do in the next few slides is to go into each of these in turn.
So the 6ခုကိုခုနတော့ဆရာကပြောတော့ပြတ်သွားပြီပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဒီဟာကိုတစ်ခုချင်းစီသွားပါမယ်ဆိုတော့ပထမဦးဆုံးအနေနဲ့ဒီအာဒီမျိုးမျိုးတော့ဒီအာမတူကွဲပြားခြားနားရင်ကျေးမှုတွေကိုအကပ်ပေးခြင်းဖြစ်ပါလေ
So the first thing that federalism can do is it can help us protect cultural diversity. And by that what I mean is in many many countries there are lots of different cultural groups. And often one cultural group dominates the union government, dominates the center, but there are lots of local cultural groups that are different and they're afraid of the central government.
ဆိုတော့ခါကြတော့ဒီဟာနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ဒီမတူညီမတူကွဲပြားခြားနားတဲ့ယဉ်ကျေးမှုတွေပေါ့နော်ဒီမတူကွဲပြားခြားနားတဲ့ယဉ်ကျေးမှုတွေကိုလည်းပဟိုကနေပြီးတော့ဝင်ရောက်ပြီးတော့အဲဆိုမိုးပြီးတော့ခါကြတော့အဲ ลงไก่มั้ยဆိုလို့ရှင်ဒီကက်တကယ်မှာအဲသူ့ရဲ့ဒေတာချင်းစီမှာရှိတဲ့ဒီအဲမတူကွဲပြားခြားနာတော့ယဉ်ကျေးမှုရှိတဲ့သူတွေကဒါကိုဆိုးရွံ့ထိတ်လန့်မှာဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့အခါကျတော့ဒီလိုအရာမျိုးတွေဟာဆိုလို့ရှင်အဒီပြည်နယ်ကသူ့ရဲ့အဲသူ့နယ်ပတ်သက်တဲ့သူ့ရဲ့ဒီအယဉ်ကျေးမှုအဲမတူကွဲပြားတဲ့ယဉ်ကျေးမှုတွေကိုပြည်နယ်ကခေါင်းခေါင်းမုံမုံကာကွယ်ပေးနိုင်ပါ yari, but biro kajoro badazaga and badazaga nepatere jam yari bono.
Now, these local cultural groups just want to live in their own way, but they're worried that if the central government has all the power, they'll be governed by that dominant cultural group in the center. And as a result, they won't be able to live in their own way. Now, the federalism answer here is give power to the states so that local people can more govern themselves in their own way.
So, Diniama, Dinega, do ye, Dine Ninega, do ye the Matuni, Matuqueja Chana, Yinchimu, go to Nine Kanka Momo, and Nanin Kai Drenine, Arajamulu.
This, of course, is the quality of federalism that most people in Burma have been talking about for the longest time. And that's because the ethnic nationalities feel that they have a different culture from the culture in Naypyidaw, and they want to govern themselves in their own way. And for that reason, they want power pushed closer to the people. But here's the thing. Burma is really culturally diverse. And this is not just a question of ethnicity, because Bama people themselves have many different cultures all across the country. And so Burman farmers in Sagaing Division are as different from the culture in Naypyidaw as are Kachin people in Kachin State.
Okay. So the Burma die ane tha go ga tu a imadan ma di matu kwe pya cha na mu le ne lwan chong ni de di tbo tba wa shi de bo no. So ro kha ja lo di lu myo su ri ma be matu kwe pya de yin chi mu shi da ma ho be ne.
Yeah, we often speak of Bama people as though it's a single monolithic culture, but in fact, we know it's not. There's tremendous variation.
Now,
for many years, I was blacklisted when I first started doing Burma work, and so I could not come legally into central Burma. So I had to walk across the border into the liberated zones to visit people. And I saw some of the cultural diversity then.
So the Chinoa who longer calari masuin chino ni the any blacklist in the ma twin can care no tajamolo chino ni ne ma bidego win be or tete win chino ni ne look like some yakwe mishi kebu and I imagine on in a di nima piye nebono I imagine wa di look look kere so I imagine or trigger aga
But for a while, starting in 2012, I was allowed to go into Burma. I got some visas. I expect I'm now blacklisted again, but for a time I could go in. And I tried very hard to see as many different places in Burma as I could. And again, what I was just so struck by was there's enormous cultural variation here. And local Bama people were very inclined to say to me that the people in Naypyidaw, they really have a different culture. They don't understand us, which is exactly the same thing that Kachin people in Michina said to me, or that Hmong people in Moyameng said to me, and so forth. So, giving the states power to protect cultural diversity would help everybody, and in more or less the same way. And the only people who wouldn't help are the centralizers, who want to keep all of the power in their own hands. Now, the second thing that federalism can do is it can allow the states to protect vulnerable populations, vulnerable groups of people. That very often we weary that the central government just doesn't care about local people because they're very far away. And so the central government doesn't feel an obligation to care for them. Now, the central government might be hostile towards local people because they're of a different ethnic group, but that's not the only reason. Sometimes the central government is hostile just because those local people are far away and they just don't care about them, even when they're in the same ethnic group. And so we see this even in countries that are more or less monoethnic with just one ethnic group. And of course, we all are feeling this right now, that the Tamada is oppressing everybody, Burman people and non-Burman people alike. Everybody fears the central government because it's hostile to almost all local people who really want democracy and individual rights and federalism.
ဒီလိုမျိုးအခြေအနေကိုကျွန်တော်တို့လက်ရှိမှာလဲကြုံတွေ့နေရတာဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ဒီဘဟုဆိုးရကဒီလူတွေအားလုံးလူတွေအဖြစ်နှိပ်ချုပ်ချင်တာရှိပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့ဒါကိုသူ့ကိုဆိုးရင်ထိတ်လန့်ကြောက်လန့်နေရပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ဒီဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီဟိုကနေပြီးတော့
Now, for many years, just as an example, people in Michina have been telling me they really want a local police force. They don't want a police force sent from the national government because they're worried that a national police force will kill them, will shoot them, will oppress them. And so they want a police force made up of their neighbors. And that's been true in Michina for a long time. But I bet it's true right now in Mandalay as well, that the people in Mandalay really hope that they have a local police force rather than Tatmadaw troops shooting them down in the streets. So, giving to the states the power to protect vulnerable populations would actually help everyone, non-Burman people, but also Burman people. The only people who wouldn't help are the centralizers who want to keep all of the power in their own hands. The third thing that states can do is they can encourage participatory democracy. For democracy to work, it's a good thing for as many people as possible to be involved in their self-government. And that's a lot easier to do at the local level than it is to do if you have to go to NAPIDA to influence the government. So if we push power closer to the people, more people will get involved in government. Now, that's good for the people who get involved because they feel like they have some influence on government. It's also good for the government because it means the government will have more accurate information about what local people really want. And so if we want real, true participatory democracy, we really want federalism.
So the pine gani biro the pine ye lo sang huri, pine soya ye lo sang huri ma le, piduri ye te te wu wu pao bin hu, but ni get the pao bin hu, don't ပါဝင်မှုတွေကအင်မတန်မှအရေးကြီးပြီးတော့ခါကြတော့ဒီလိုလှုပ်ရှားအဖြစ်ပြီးနဲ့အစိုးရကိုလည်းဒီဒီမိုကရေစီစနစ်ရှင်တန်ပေါက်ဖွားရေးမှာလည်းအင်မတန်မှအချက်ချာကြပြီးတော့ဒီလိုပါဝင်မှုတိုက်တွန်းတာဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အင်မတန်မှကောင်းပါတယ်
Yeah. If you would like some contemporary examples of this, examples that are around right now. Think about the civil disobedience movement. This is actually a kind of participatory democracy. The people are trying to take power into their own hands. And the CDM is profoundly local. It grows up in particular places when people come together to try to resist the Tatmadaw. The same is true of the general strike movement. The same is true of the PDFs. All of these are local because that's where people can respond to circumstances. If everything, if all the power were concentrated in NAPIDA, there would be none of these movements.
Okay, so ဒီရနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးဥမာပြည်သူတွေရဲ့ပူးပေါင်းပါဝင်မှုကဘယ်လောက်အရေးကြီးလဲဆိုတာကိုကြည့်မယ်ဆိုလို့ရှင်လက်ရှိအနေထားမှာကျွန်တော်တို့အထင်သားမြင်ရတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဒါကတော့ဒီပေးရမယ်ဆိုရင် CDM လို့ဆောင်တဲ့အခါမှာ civil disobedience ကိုလှုပ်ဆောင်တဲ့အခါမှာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်တကယ်ပြည်သူတွေရဲ့အရင်နှစ်သေးချာကနေပေါက်ဖွားလာတဲ့လှုပ်ရှားမှုဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ဒါဟာအင်မတန်မှဒီထိရောက်ပြီးတော့အင်မတန်မှခိုင်မာတဲ့လှုပ်ရှားမှုဖြစ်တယ်အလားတူပဲဒီPDF ဆိုတဲ့အလားတူပဲပြီးတော့ခါကြတော့ဒီအထွေထွေသပိတ်ပေါ့နော်ဒါတွေအားလုံးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ပြည်သူတွေကဒီလက်ဒီအနေထားကိုဒီမိုကရေစီရရှိရေးအ atong khon sai lop saung cha le so na wo twei mi ya ba le da ri ha so lo shin yin thin da myin da le upama thin da myin da le a chi ni le phit ba le
Now participatory democracy is important for everybody not just for the ethnic nationalities but for Burman people as well and that's why we see the CDM movement everywhere in Burma including in heavily Burman areas and that's an indication that all of Burma wants federalism they want the ability to influence things on a local level
so ro di ha ma imitan ma ye ji de a chat ka ba le so ra ka ja democracy ya shi bu atwa ma a lou ye pa win mu atu de kwa chou ban saung ye mu phit par de so chano ro lun ga de kala yo pyan le tong tat pi ji lai me so lo shin ye pi du ri ye takhe net pa win mu ga athin da mi ya da phit par de da chaung ma lo da ha im du rai atwa ye ji de pi du ti ye chin si ti yauk chin si atwa le imitan ma ye ji de lou sha saung ye mu phit pi lo da ga pa wo the hat si de le da pa wo yu တာဘာကိုထိဟက်စေတယ်လဲဆိုလို့ရှိရင်မြန်မာပြည်တနန်တလျားမှာရှိတဲ့ပြည်သူတွေအားလုံးဒီဗမာလူမျိုးတွေပဲနေတဲ့နေရာတွေမှာတော့ဆန္ဒပြမှုတွေဒီဖက်ဒီမိုကရေစီကိုဘယ်လောက်လိုလားလဲဆိုတာကိုအဲဒီဆန္ဒထုတ်ဖော်တာတွေအများကြီးကျွန်တော်တို့တွေ့မြင်ရပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ဒါကဘာလို့ဆိုလို့ဖော်ပြတယ်လဲဆိုလို့ရှိရင်တနိုင်ငံလုံးမှာရှိတဲ့ပြည်သူတွေဟာဖက်ဒရယ်စနစ်ကိုလိုလိုလားလားတောင်းရှိကြတယ်ဒီမိုကရေစီစနစ်ရဖို့အတွက်လည်းဘယ်လောက်အတူခုန်ဆိုင်ကြိုးပမ်းလဲဆိုတာကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့လှုပ်ရှားဆောင်ရွက်မှုတွေကနေ
So, giving the states the power to encourage participatory democracy would help everybody except the centralizers.
ဒါကြောင့်မလို့တီနေတီနေရဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အနာရီကို PN အနှင်းလိုက်မယ်ဒီလို PN အနှင်းလိုက်ခြင်းအဖြစ်နိုင်ငံရဲ့ဒီမိုကရေစီကုပြောင်းမှုရဒီမိုကရေစီရရှိမှုအခြေအနေတွေမှာပြည်သူတွေရဲ့ပါဝင်မှုဟာအလုံးအတွက်အကျိုးကျေးဇူးဖြစ်စေမှာဖြစ်ပါတယ်အကျိုးကျေးဇူးမဖြစ်စေတာဆိုလို့ဒီပဟိုဝါဒီဓမ္မတွေပဲဖြစ်ပါလိမ့်မယ်
Okay now the fourth advantage here is that states can take advantage of local knowledge sometimes local people understand their own problems better than anybody else better than people in the capital
so စတုထအနေနဲ့ကတော့ဒီအတကျရှိရပေါ့နော်ပြည်နယ်အနေနဲ့ဆိုတော့ဒီဒီဒေတန္တရဗဟုသုတကပြည်နယ်ကပို့ပြီးတော့ဒီအတာချက်ရှိတယ်ဆိုတော့တချို့ဒီတချို့ကိစ္စတွေမှာဒေတာတွင်လူတွေကပဲသူတို့နဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့ကြေတနာကိုသူတို့ပဲသိတယ်ဥပမာကိုဝန်းနာကိုသာသိဆိုတာမျိုးပေါ့နော်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့ပြည်နယ်အနေနဲ့ကဒီသူရဲ့ပတ်သက်ဆက်တဲ့အကြောင်းအရာတွေကိုစီမံဆောင်ရွက်တဲ့နေရာမှာသူသားလေးရဲ့အနာနဲ့ဆေးနဲ့တွေ့ရပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့သူသားလေးရဲ့ကောင်းကောင်းမွန်မွန်ထက်ထက်ဝင်သိရဖြစ်ပါတယ်
Yeah, just as an example, local people often know when their rivers and streams are getting polluted much earlier than people in the capital do. And so it's fairly common in federal systems to give the states a role in environmental protection, because local people just understand that problem better than people in the capital.
ဒီဒေတန်တရမှာရှိတဲ့သူတွေကသူတို့ရဲ့မြေချောင်းအင်းအိုင်တွေကဘယ်လိုမျိုးညံ့နွမ်းသွားတယ်ဘယ်လိုမျိုးပဲဘယ်လိုမျိုးညံ့နွမ်းသွားတယ်ဆိုတာကိုသူတို့ကတခြားဘဟုကလူတွေတခြားဒေတာလူတွေထက်သူတို့ကကောင်းကောင်းသိပါတယ်။ဒါကြောင့်မို့လို့ဒီလိုမျိုးတွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ဒီအကင်တွယ်ဆောင်ရွက်တဲ့အခါမှာသူနဲ့ဆက်ဆက်တဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတွေကိုတော့ပြည်နယ်ကိုပဲပေးတင်ပါတ
just true for the ethnic nationalities. Everywhere, people understand some of their problems better than people in the capital. So giving the states this power would help everyone except the centralizers.
So di ni ta ga di lu myo su ri ni ye de ta ma be di ni ta phit da ma ho bo na ta nai ngan lo ma di lu ni ta phit shi le bo no so tu ye tu ywa bo tu ne pa chang ya tu ye tu ywa ga be kaung kaung mon mon ti ye da wa tu ba kaung kaung mon mon kai dre saung ywa nai ma phit ba le so ro pi ne go lu di lu lou pai khwin a na ri go pi ne go at nin chin ha
Okay. The fifth advantage to having sovereign states is that state governments can just act more quickly to deal with problems. And sometimes we need to deal with problems very quickly.
So the Pisma Chakaro, အဲ့လေအမြန်လုတ်ကန်ဆောင်ရွက်နိုင်တယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဒီပြည်နယ်အစိုးရဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သူ့ရဲ့ဒေတာတွေမှာရှိတဲ့ပြဿနာတွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့အလှည့်အမြန်ဆုံးဒီတုံတုံပြန်ဆောင်ရွက်နိုင်တဲ့ဒီအစိုးရဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဒါကြောင့်မို့လို့သူ့အနေနဲ့ဒီလိုမျိုးအလှည့်အမြန်ဆောင်ရွက်ရတော့မယ့်အကြောင်းအရာတွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်ရင်တော့လုတ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာဟာသူ့စီမှာပဲရှိတယ်မှာလေ
So the states should be given power over those subjects that require a quick response. And a good example here actually is the pandemic, that when COVID first arrived in federal countries, it was the states that responded most immediately. Now, in the long run, you're going to need a federal role as well. But for the quick response, states are in a better position to do that.
Okay. So the Jamalu, the Pinego, Tanepatapio, Lopanquingu, Peter Mare, so Ubumat, Anika song, Lopanquin Peter Neta Madalin, Tua, Lilin Nemian, Dibo Matompian, some kind red, some Yanai Matipare, Tintanian Dare Umat, Kujano Piame Solution, Dika Bikala, no, so the Dinatown General Jungriare, Dika Bima Solution, the COVID-19 Gabibo, no, the coronavirus Gabima Solution, the Federalism Gentle and Nang and the Solution, Droha, Dinari got Chachenta, Dompian, some Yanai Nebono, Dompian, some Yanai Quilla Sheep. Solution, Aishi Maradun in the Boho Federal Soya, Boho Soya.
Now, right now, the Delta variant is very bad in Shin State, and the SAC is doing nothing about it. It's the local people who are trying to take care of themselves. Now, that's because the SAC doesn't really care. That's an example of hostility and indifference. But it's also because the SAC takes a long time to do anything. And local people can respond in a quicker way.
Okay. So lashi ni ma nange chi ni ma solution le uma pe ya me so ye di delta myo kwe bo no coronavirus ha solution imitan ma di chin chin ne o a pyin tan di thon nat ni ya bo no di tu ri ya di kap be yoga tan o alu le khan ni ya de di chain ma sac a ni ne tu wa ba ma lou kai saung yet da ri ba ma ma shi u bo no so ro da a chuno a ni ne uma pe chin me phit pi lo kha ja ro di lo a nei tha myo ma pi tu ri ne na ga ko thu ko tha lou
But again, all throughout Myanmar, in Burman areas and non-Burman areas alike, there are problems that require speedy action. So this is not an ethnic issue. Giving states this power will help everyone except the centralizers.
So the tenang yang lama le, di lumiu ni tarik ya, si jari bano. Tapi jom lu di lubang kau anari di lumiu, ni niye kain dua sahaja perlu ada jauh yari. Ni niye topi sahaja perlu ada jauh yari. Ma di nego ana ane lai cina, alam lu ayam cinci itu di jujur susi zima cipai. Dame diaura di pahuari temari yaro di lumiu di nego ana ane jemur terus ni cai mama hubau.
Okay, now. The final advantage to having state sovereigns is that the central government might sooner or later become a corrupt or oppressive, and states should have the powers necessary to resist the union government if it becomes corrupt or oppressive.
So the settlement of Chagaro, the Bohu Suyago, the Abdelan Tengjang Navono. Jalan tengjam jam cepat le, baru le sura jaro di bahu suya ga pilihan ni ni bono, belum yo pilihan ni ni so di agri laisa le bahu suya pilihan ni, biro kajaro pinai cuci le bahu suya pilihan ni, belum yo ni thama solution di ni ga di lo ni thari ku ku kembu donlan ni bu de tu ni ni di lupa kui anaga lupa le.
Now. At this particular moment in history, of course, this concern is especially relevant. I do not believe that the SAC is a legal government. Nonetheless, it is acting as though it were the central government. And that meant that in practice, the central government became utterly oppressive overnight when the coup occurred. And one of the great advantages to state governments is if that happens, the states can help people push back, resist, check the central government.
Surakha jaro di ha ga le shi myanmar nange ye ani tha ma imdan ma sasat ni de ani tha ta khu phit ni ya bo no ba lo le surakha chuno ga ro ma thin ma di chuno ga ro sac go di tayon ye so ya lo ma thin ma u so ro ai ya ne atu tu di khu phit de di khu phit de kha ma so lo shin ye nya twin chin ma be SAC ini nega belauti pinai cuci biru belauti pinai biru belauti biru negor deh sura jenaru atang tanya barai sura dulu ni ni tahan solusi ye di pinai mada lomlau deh lomban kau anari cuci ni ne jentong ni ne anari si kem solusi ye dulu ni negor dari pinai dari ku pinai ni ne donlan ni macam barai.
And since the coup, of course. The Tatmadaw is not just oppressing the ethnic nationalities, it's oppressing everyone. We are now all oppressed alike. We are all in this together. And that means we all need to make sure that the states in the future have the tools to resist an oppressive central government.
So, Lashima solution in the SAC. Di lumiozuri ube pinai dari nego dari mahupau pemapsisi pemamahude cah lumiozuri pemapsisi nego pare so dah solusian cunoru ni ne di tengah zani cunoru naunaga majaro di lumiozuri pinai dari di lumiozuri nego muri ku jangan le tonan ni ne yang dia tu kong mumu cunoru ni ne di sabu lubare so ai mana tu setema be di pinai ga di lumiozuri tonan ni ne ana lupan kui ni ga tu masih bulu apa.
Now, the most obvious example of this is that the states will need some kind of armed security force in order to protect local people when the central government becomes oppressive. And that means, again, I think that Burmans and non-Burmans alike can agree on this at this point, that it's a really good thing right now that the KNU, the KIO, all the other groups have arms and that they are organized so that they can protect people against the Tatmadaw.
Bahawa ni biar negor dari kawan lain buat kau semua bilang tu keluar apa le so kini ni ni tu ye kubai tu ye kubai tak sibuk lupa le dama dari tu ye tidur itu kawan lain macam apa le so di china ini dama kawan dengan china biar ini dama kau mana china apa le baru le solusi macam kiai upsi si kian upsi si cahaya tain dalam negan tolong ini presiden upsi si terus hati terus ye di ni di dama terus ni ne kong mumu suzi supret hari tadi si barai dah jangan malu terus dia terus di ni masih ye tidur itu
So giving the states this power again would help everyone except the centralizers.
So the
So fundamentally, then, federalism is about pushing power closer to the people. Throughout the world, people feel that the central government is too far away, is not connected to them, does not care about people like them.
That
means that pushing power closer to the people will help everyone throughout Burma. Burman people and non-Burman people alike.
So the piduri the anari bono di lo pankwe anago pidu ne aniga soma tachin ha so lo shin ye bama tacha do di bama ma hou de lu myo ri twet phit se tacha do di lu myo su ri twet ba phit se imatan ma kaung ne di ana khwe wi pan cha jin tong hu phit ba de.
Now, I know you all know who this is and what this salute is all about. And in the Hunger Games, the drive among the people, of course, was for democracy, but it was equally for federalism, that the demand here was to break power out of the central government and push it closer to the people. And if we believe, therefore, in pushing power closer to the people, what we do is we believe in federalism, because that's what it's all about.
So the Hunger Game yet the Zasangura Along Tijamelo Tamare, Sorata, the Yanni Projuru, Pau Tilu Yale, Sura Kajaro, the Lopanque Anarigu, Pidurine, Nikaswa, Tata Biame, Radi Anna Pawari, Pidurin Nama, Shimadali, the Bohoye, the Flamu Choka and Murigo, Tunine, the Pinesuyaga, Dona Nima Pitlube, the Luate Gentom Huri, Anna Gentom Huriga, Piduria, Nikasom Dao, Lakan Gentom Nima Pipare.
Now, federalism then helps everybody, Burman and non-Burman alike. So we might ask, why is it controversial? Why do people get so excited about it? And I believe the reason is that it requires us to be patient with variation. We have to accept the fact that different people want to do things in different ways. And sometimes it's really hard to accept that fact, that different people, that people just sometimes view things in a really different way from us, and we have to be okay with that.
Controversial chinabono. So Rakajaro, the general in the Dilumu, Mapipo Draga, Balule, the Inyumpawaya, Mapipo Drabono, Balule, Solushi, the Inyumpawaya, Balupin in the Solushi, Genoruga, the Matuguebiamui, the Pianglery Boma, Genorua, Sishi, Dikamu, Shibu, Lodalo, Daga, Alo Drabono, Yibuya Apsi, Dilumu, Sishi, Dikamua.
Now, let me just say a few words about this issue and then I'll finish my remarks for today. The point in federalism is that different states will do things differently. So the states will be different from each other. But the key thing to understand is there's nothing wrong with variation. Disagreement is normal. So we should be allowed to do things in our own way.
Okay. Professor, could you please?
Oh, of course. Yes, of course. There we go.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome.
So the lonely tama so she the dine federal cinema bono the matunire dineriga matunire muara di chama bio look and song your daga through to accounts on chibare the niapian solution dine to cousin si dangale duni mam hoba bono daga la dreamale daga mamare da le chitin meet up chibare so the a young lady to grab ya muriga mayuna mishiba so the bomber duni muria bowman. ပုံမှန်ဖြစ်နေကြဖြစ်တယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီဘောမတူညီမှုတွေအတရားနဲ့တရားအမြင်ပွဲလွဲမှုတွေကအထိုက်အလျောက်ကတော့ဒါကတော့ဒါလက်ခံလို့ရတယ်အနေထားရှိပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့အဓိကကတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့လုတ်ကံရမယ်အကြောင်းအရာတွေကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ရည်ခံမြည်ခံတဘာဝနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အနေထားတွေလုတ်ဆောင်ဖို့အတွက်ကဒီ
Now, let's look for a minute at the contrasting view, because I think many people take this view that I'm about to explain. And I think we have to admit that probably some all of us have felt this at one point or another. We all of us believe that there's probably only one right way to do anything, right? We're convinced there's a right way or a best way. And to do otherwise would be to do the wrong thing. And if we talk about it, eventually we'll figure out how to do the things the right way. And then that's how we should all do it. There should be one outcome and we should all do things in the same way.
So Dima, ตะคู่บ่เนาะตะคัดเลซะลงสิยดิตะคู่แล้วแม่นเนี่ยမျိုးตะคู่แล้วแม่นนี่ပြီးတော့ဒီအနေဒီလမ်းကြောင်းအတိုင်းပဲဒီတခုတွေပဲလုတ်ရမယ်ဆိုတာမျိုးကိုလူတော်တော်များများကယုံကြည်ကြတယ်ပေါ့เนาะဒါတနည်းအားဖြင့်ဆိုလို့ရှင်ဒီဒါပဲမှန်တယ်ဒီတိုင်းပဲလုတ်ရမယ်တခြားနည်းနဲ့လုတ်တယ်ဆိုရင်ဒါအမှားဖြစ်တယ်ပေါ့เนาะအဲ့လိုမျိုးတော်တော်များများယုံကြည်ရပါယုံကြည်ကြတယ်ပေါ့เนาะဒါမဲ့ဒီ ကျန်လန်ဆွေးနွေးမယ်တစ်ခါနဲ့တစ်ခါဒီဆွေးနွေးမှုတွေကနေတစ်စစ်သူကမှန်ကန်တဲ့လမ်းမှန်နီးမှန်လမ်းမှန်မှုသူကစောင့်ကြည့်ပေးလို့ရှိပါတယ်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့ဒီဆွေးနွေးမှုတွေအပြောဆွေးနွေးမှုတွေကနေတစ်စစ်ဒီလူတွေကဒီမှန်ကန်တဲ့နီးလန်းတွေကိုရှာဖွေတွေ့ရှိတော့မှဖြစ်ပြီးတော့ဒီလိုမျိုးဆွေးနွေးမှုတွေကလုတ်ကိုလုတ်ဆောင်တဲ့အရာတွေဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့
Okay, good. This is especially true for countries that have lived under authoritarian rule, under military rule for a long time. Because military rulers always take the view that there's one best way to do things, and they're going to tell the people what it is, and then everybody has to do it that way, the ruler's way.
โอเคสรุปว่าดิตะชะနိုင်ငံဒီတချို့နိုင်ငံတွေမှာဆိုတာဒါတကယ်ကိုမှန်ကန်တယ်ပေါ့เนาะဆိုတော့ဒီဘယ်လိုနိုင်ငံတွေလဲဆိုတော့ခါကြတော့အာနာရှင်ဆန်နဲ့အုပ်ချုပ်မှုတွေကြားထဲမှာပေါင်းများစွာနေခဲ့ရတဲ့နိုင်ငံတွေဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီအုပ်ချုပ်သူတွေဒီအာနာရှင်ဆန်နဲ့အုပ်ချုပ်မှုတွေအောက်မှာနေတဲ့နေနဲ့ကဒီသူအုပ်ချုပ်သူတွေဟာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သူတို့ရဲ့နိုင်ငံသားတွေကိုသူက ဒီတိန့်သွင်းစည်းရုံးနဲ့ဘယ်လိုအဲ့လိုတိန့်သွင်းစည်းရုံးနဲ့ခါကျတော့ဒီလန်းတစ်ခုတည်းကပဲလမ်းမှန်ဖြစ်တယ်ဒီလန်းကနေပဲဒီလန်းကနေပဲဒါကနိမ့်မှန်လမ်းမှန်ဒီလမ်းပဲရှိတယ်ပေါ့နော်အဲ့ဒါမျိုးကိုတည်သူရဲ့ပြည်သူတွေကိုဒီအာနာရှင်ဆန်နဲ့အုပ်ချုပ်သူတွေအာနာရှင်ဆန်နဲ့အစိုးရတွေကလက်ခံယုံကြည်စေတယ်တိန့်သွင်းစည်းရုံးတွေရှိတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့သူနဲ့အမြင်မတူတဲ
Now, what that means is the dissenters, people who do it a different way, are thought to be destructive. The trouble, though, is this attitude, this is just domination again. The idea that there's one right way to do things, and I know what it is, and I'm going to force you to do it that way, that's the impulse to domination, not the impulse to love. Now, this impulse to domination, this is especially true of military rulers. But I think all of us have it to some extent. I know that sometimes I think I figured out the best way to do things, and then I get impatient with people who do it in a different way. And I have to keep reminding myself, that's not a good attitude. That's a really bad attitude. And in fact, I need good friends like Liz and Ami to remind me this is not my best self, that I should be much more patient with variation.
So the dilu ni dilu myo di didalan me shi le dilan ga ni be twa ya me so re ha myo di amyin takhu le o be kan tat pyo paung lou pyo lou kai na so lo shin yin da ga mi man lan ma ma hou bo no so upama so lo shin chuno a ni ne a lou takhu ko lu tyaw ko lou sei me pro kha ja le tu a chuno tin tha de chuno mhet yu tha de ni lan tai tu ma lou so ra kha ma chuno sait de ma da hma le da ma hou ဒါဒါကြီးကလွဲနေပြီဆိုပြီးတော့ကျွန်တော်တောက်လျှောက်ဒါကြီးကိုအကောင်းမမြင်မနဲ့အဲ့လိုမျိုးသွားနေမယ်ဆိုလို့ရှင်ဒါမှမှန်ပါဘူးဆိုတော့အဲ့မှာကျွန်တော်အနေနဲ့ဒီကျွန်တော်ရဲ့တွေးခေါ်မျှော်မြင်တွေးခေါ်ချက်တွေယူဆချက်တွေဟာမှားနေရဲဆိုတဲ့ဟာကိုထောက်ပြပေးမယ်လို့ပေါ့ကိုင်းကောင်းနေလို့ရပေါ့နော်အဲ့လိုမျိုးဥပမာပါပဲဆိုတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့ကဒီအရာတစ်ခုတည်းရပဲဒီ
Why different states might want to do things in different ways. Why variation is just fine, that there's nothing wrong with it. The first is the states might just have different circumstances. They might have different conditions within those states. And so, for example, sometimes states have roads that are wide and straight and flat, and there's little traffic. And when that's the case, it's okay to have a very high speed limit because you can drive very fast and also safely when roads are like this.
So, so upmani ne byaw ma so lo shin land lan shi de ai land ga le che de phyaung ne phyaung pyu de di cho le cho mwe de bo no ai ma dam mae ai ma tchu di ye ye a shin kan tat de di traffic de tchu tha de bo no so di ne ne tu a land no ne ne pick de bo no ai shin ma so lo shin pi ne a ni ne di tu ye di myan nong kan tat mu ko tu a ni ne di
But in other places, the roads are narrow and they curve a lot and they're hilly. And so in order to have safe traffic, we need limit to be slower.
Okay. So speed limit
So Now, it's obvious that this is a good thing, right? That there should be variation. So why would we want to impose a single rule? Why would we want to make everybody do it in the same way?
So I don't need how much general rule about the Nilan the Mure Damobe, a general Tapa you can did that Nitaya, a door shot, low put low at this or a door shot low in Gamula.
Now, the second reason that states might do things differently is they just perceive the facts differently. Now, for example, sometimes, some places, people think nuclear power is unsafe, and so they would ban it. But in other states, people think nuclear power is safe, and it's clean, and it's efficient, and it even helps with climate change, so they would allow it. And this is a reasonable disagreement. Different people can see this in different ways, and so it's best to let people do things the way that seems best to them.
So
Now, the third reason, and maybe this is the most important, that there might be variation is that the people of different states have different values. They just look at the moral world a little differently. And we have to keep reminding ourselves that there's no guarantee that we understand the moral world perfectly. We have to have some patience for the fact that other people might understand things better than we do. And so even when they do things that we don't think are maybe the best thing, still that might be the right thing. And we should allow them to do it in their way.
Now,
just as an example, if we're suffering an economic downturn, so there's less government money, the government is going to have to find a way to reduce its personnel. It can't employ so many people. Now, in some places, what they're going to do is they're going to keep the best people, the most efficient employees, and fire everybody else. But in other states, what they're going to do is they're going to put everyone on half time. They're going to employ everybody, but just reduce the hours for everyone because they don't want any of their employees to suffer more than necessary. Now, these are both reasonable views. They're just different.
So then a better the ဘိုဆိုရနေနေပေါ့နော်သူ့ရဲ့ဒီအစိုးရမှုထမ်းတွေကိုသူချော့ချတာဖြစ်ဖြစ်ကျောင်းလဲလုပ်နိုင်ပါတယ်ဘတ်တချို့ကြတော့လဲတချို့အဲတချို့အစိုးရတွေဒီနယ်အစိုးရအစိုးရတွေကြတော့လဲအဲဒီလူဦးရေချော့ချတာမျိုးမဟုတ်ဘဲနဲ့လက်ရှိရှိထားပြီးသားအစိုးရမှုထမ်းတွေကိုပဲသူ့အနေနဲ့ဒီဆက်လက်ပြီးတော့ခန့်အပ်တာမျိုးလက်ရှိနိုင်ပါတယ်ဘတ်တချို့ဒီနယ်အစိုးရတွေမှာကြတော့ဒီအနေထားဒီစီးပွားရေး
And then finally, the people of the different states might just have different traditions. And of course, in Burma, we are extremely familiar with this, that different people might speak different languages, they might have different holidays, different marriage customs, and so forth. And at this point, I think everyone in Burma agrees there's nothing wrong with having different traditions. And so as a result, people should be allowed to do what they want to do in this respect. Traditions can really matter.
So,
So here's the summary then. Federalism benefits everyone. Therefore, federalism should not be the source of ethnic conflict because it actually helps everyone. Everyone should want it. And what we're going to talk about next time is that federalism can actually help reduce ethnic conflict by assuring that no group can dominate any other group. So Liz, let's go to questions, shall we?
Hello. We got some questions and they seemed to separate into three different categories. The first is sort of more about why should we imposism? The second would be how does federalism work? And the last one will be getting to federalism.
Okay.
So first in the why federalism categories, we had two questions were sort of about how federalism will affect the issue of inequality among groups. And they were referring to inequality between Burman people and ethnic people at the level of the whole country, and also inequality between ethnic people and minorities at the state level.
Thank you. So for the latter question, at the state level, how is this going to affect relations between Burman people and non-Burman people, and also between various minorities? We will address that at much greater length in the next session, because that's how you use federalism to reduce ethnic conflict. But this is often called the problem of minorities within minorities, that suppose that we push power closer to the people. And so now all of a sudden, it's not the Burman majority at the national level, it's some ethnic group's majority at the state level. How do we protect other minorities at the state level? And the answer is, it's a super good question. It ends up needing a technical answer because we end up needing to talk about the various tools we have to make sure that everybody gets protected. But I really want to affirm the impulse here, right? Which is to say that just pushing power closer to the states doesn't save us, that there are still risks of ethnic oppression and we still have to be aware of them. Parts of constitutional design are big concept, big picture things. Others are nitty gritty tools. And here we're in the area of nitty gritty tools. So I promise an answer, it's just we can't really go into it at great length right now. Now, at the macroscopic level, how would this affect the issue of inequality between Burman and non-Burman people? I think clearly it would help it if it is done right, because it's going to allow more people to feel like they are in the governing majority in their area. And that's the whole goal of federalism, is that, as we talked about in the last time, that we really want to make sure everybody feels like they have self-determination. But if they're a minority all the time, they're going to feel like they're losing all the time. And part of what happens with federalism is if you push power closer to the people, the local groups are more alike than people at the national level. And so more of them can feel like they are in the winning majority. Now, again, always with the proviso, there are going to be local minorities too, and we have to worry about them.
So moving on to the second category, how does federalism work? And these are more sort of technical questions. So the first one, concerning federalism in the USA, in the lecture, it says that the union can't take the power of the states, but aren't all the 50 states required to accept all the decisions of the Supreme Court? And if so, it seems like the central power of the Supreme Court does actually prevail over the states. And Ami, do you want to translate that one?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. Right. The translation for the last one. Ami, can you kind of translate the last interaction?
The one you have commented?
Yeah, I don't know if you remember that. I'm very sorry. I just forgot about this. I thought I was talking to Liz, who speaks English.
I think I can summarize that one.
All right.
Yeah, let me try my best.
Okay.
So the federalism ma di boho soya ne di dine soya jare ma ana kwewe mo imedama a yeji de ala du be di kuna me tware mi kone ma pare ha bono di federalism ma di inequality bono so di the bomb palauti tayamushile prokaja the lunesuri to the federalism got balloon palautimia palumia akagwe pinai melesura ne patabio migo mitwara pite so di bomba siani negaro the chella di bomba atanizon tuni ne the lame lecturima ve to a lare lecturima to a bunch of nine on juza dome lupura pibare.
Yeah. Okay, great. So now it's a really good and interesting question, right? That here's the question. The states have a certain domain and the union has a certain domain. So the states have certain subjects and the union has certain subjects. And what I just said is that as long as the states stay within their subjects, they're sovereign. They don't have to do what the union tells them to do.
Okay. So Adinia Madi, Baho Soya Shime, Dine Soya Shime,
Now, the complication is we have to know where that dividing line is, what the states are allowed to do and what the union is allowed to do under the Constitution. And so for that reason, we need a constitutional interpreter to figure out where the line is. And in the United States, that's the Supreme Court.
ဒီပြည်နယ်ရဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတွေကြားထဲမှာဒီစီးချထားတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့အဲ့ဒီစီးကဘယ်မှာလဲအဲ့ဒီစီးကဘယ်လိုမျိုးလဲဆိုတာကိုဖွဲ့စည်းပုံအခြေခံဥပဒေမှာဒီထည့်သွင်းရေးဆွဲပြီးတော့သတ်မှတ်ထားပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ဒီအမေရိကရဲ့အနေအထားလေးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီဘဟုရဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်ဒီနယ်ရဲ့လုပ်ပိုင်ခွင့်တွေကိုဒီစီးချထားပေးတဲ့အရာပြီးတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီဖွဲ့စ
If you believe that the Supreme Court is completely objective and neutral and unbiased, that argument works, right? You've got the states in their domain, the union in their domain, and then this objective Supreme Court telling you where the constitutional line is between the two domains.
The Supreme Court ka dhamma dhaitan cha cha song phet de dhamma dhaitan cha cha di lo myo lou pan khwe ana ne patat lo kai dwe de so de ha ko te ni ne yong ji ye lak khan ne so lo shin yin no da shin ne bo no di ya di bo ma dhamma yin paw sa ma shin ba phet lo le so Supreme Court ka da ko di possible chicken ubi ye atay pe wo anat de lo phwin so de ka ma tu wa myat myat tat tat la lai mu chi ba ne dhamma dhaitan cha cha
Yeah. The problem is there are many people, and I am one of them, who do not really believe the Supreme Court is truly neutral and objective and unbiased. And in particular, and this is where the question is coming from, remember the Supreme Court is actually part of the federal government. So you would predict that it's going to be in favor of federal power. And in fact, that's what we have seen, that the Supreme Court has expanded the federal domain over time, attracted the state domain. And so we might conclude is the Supreme Court is actually a bad body to make these decisions about federalism.
ဒီဆိုပရီးမ်ကော့ကိုအယုံမယုံကြည်ရပါတော့ဘာလို့လဲဆိုတော့ဒီဆိုပရီးမ်ကော့ကဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဘဟုအစိုးရရဲ့တစိတ်တပိုင်းဖြစ်တယ်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့အနေနဲ့ဒီအရေးအရာတွေကိုဆုံးဖြတ်တဲ့အခါမှာဒီအမှုကိစ္စတွေကိုစီရင်ဆုံးဖြတ်တဲ့အခါမှာဓမ္မဒိဋ္ဌိထံကြကြဆုံးပြောခါကြတော့ရှိဘူးဆိုတဲ့ဟာမျိုးကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ကဘလိုက်မှုမရှိဘဲနဲ့ဆုံးဖြတ်မယ်လို့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကတ
Now, I think there's a lesson here for Burma, and so I really appreciate the question. Once we create a federal system for Burma, somebody is going to need to decide where the boundary is between the state domain and the union. And it would probably be a very bad idea to make that person the federal constitutional court. We're going to need some other kind of federalism tribunal to figure out where the lines are.
So dima ye ji da bo no so dilo myo me ko me pe de atwa le chano jesu ten ne ba lo le so ra kha ja ro di ani lou pai kwe ga boho ye lou pai kwe ban ma le di ne ye lou pai kwe ban ma le so ra go di di si cha tha pe de di yan dia ani ne ga di yan dia shi bo im lo at de so da ha federal ta yong le phit chin ma phit ne bo no ကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့တည်ချာဒီ federal ခုံရုံးလဲကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့ရှင်းနိုင်တယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဒါဒီဟာကနေတစင်သူကဒီဒီဘိုးရဲလို့ပြင်ပြီးဒီနေရဲလို့ပြင်ပြီးဒီကိုသူ့အနေနဲ့တတ်မှတ်မှတ်ကြည့်မယ်အနာကျင့်သုံးမှုမှာလဲသူ့အနေနဲ့အမြဲတစေဒါကိုဒီ At some point, we might do a whole session on tribunals, because, of course, these are the people who will have the ultimate decision-making authority about how broad the state's powers are. So, to get a change up in the simple solution, the now lame the Pinjabu Changu Lira Male, Genoa, the federal tribunal, federal colonel, but that Piro Genon in a tablet, a Ted and Piro Pucha Tobu, a regional a year. So the Palauti at the Dinari, Lo Banguini, Bohuri, Lo Banguini, Palauti, the Genoro Nine, that was some GBO Diboma, Genoro Blue Kind Dress, Samuel Nimula Surago, Tapio Genoro Lila Dona Machapare.
And because Burma is a unique country, I believe that it will need a uniquely structured federalism. And so we'll need to have a long discussion about it, to think outside the box, to think about what Burma in particular needs, as opposed to what the United States does. Okay, Liz, what else?
So we've had a few questions sort of come in the meantime. So our three categories might not stay, but within the federalism, how does federalism work category, there seems to be a subcategory coming through of federalism and the military, how that might work. So the first question was, in some states, such as Shan State, there are many ethnic armed groups. Yep. Will there be any conflict or competition between them for power and resources if federalism occurs?
Okay, great question. All right, so we can design a federal system. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me translate the question.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks.
All right.
Okay,
so we all hope that within the next few years, we'll have real federalism and real democracy and real constitutional government. And at that point, we'll need to think about what will happen to all these groups that have guns? Because, of course, they're potentially worrisome. Now, there are a whole range of options here, and I think we need to think about all of our options in trying to figure out the best future for Burma.
So,
Now, the Tamada, of course, would ideally have all of the guns and make everybody else give up all of their arms. But at this point, I think we have reason to think that's not a really healthy option for Burma, that people are going to need to keep hold of their guns just in case the Tatmadaw ever takes over again.
So that in the Amadi Tamaroga, the Lenadi Alunga, the Tusima Beshia Mabono, so Lenadi Alunga to Abe Tanchome, so that the Bo you san it to a shigabo. The Metaga Genogaro Temare, the Ayaro, Labrima, Napsina, and Bono, Brocajarota, Mangan Bio Nata, a drink called Moho, Bono, Balunas or a Cajaro.
Now, how might that work? Well, almost everybody these days, I think, are thinking that the states might be allowed to maintain some kind of armed force, some kind of security force. And that's fairly common in federal systems around the world. that the state armed forces are not always called armies. In fact, that's relatively rare, but they're commonly called a security force or a law enforcement force or something like that.
So I have a dilemma in the time I don't know what the letter in my bone.
But here's the thing. Everybody's thinking, I think a lot of people are thinking, that the EAOs will become forces. But the key thing to understand is that there will be a change. And that is that the civilian government must be supreme. And that means the civilian government will end up having jurisdiction over these armed forces. So the EAOs cannot in the long run stay independent in the way that they're staying independent now.
Okay,
now I want to stress this shouldn't necessarily happen right away. The EAOs obviously right now need to maintain their independence. But once we have a truly good federal and democratic system in Burma, the EAOs will need to subordinate themselves to the civilian government, just as the Tatmadaw will need to subordinate itself to the union government at the union level.
Now,
the legal answer to this question, therefore, is fairly straightforward. There are all these armed groups in Shan State, and they're all going to be subordinate to the Shan State government. And so the Shan State government is going to have to figure out what to do under these circumstances, but it's going to be vested in them to figure that out.
Now,
there are going to be lots of options available to the Shan State government as well. It could decide it's going to create a single state security force and bring all those groups in, or it could also say, which happens in some American states, that even at a more local level, they're going to allow to maintain armed security forces. But these are going to be hard questions of judgment, and it's not possible to answer them in the abstract. We're going to have to think about this on a state-by-state basis.
So the original chinka taxes are coming on us so that the now lame in the time down your chimps it is or casual. Let's see in the general.
Yeah, I really, really appreciate the question, though, because, of course, when things start to change, they often change quickly. And so we need to think about questions like this in advance. So we start to have some answers in our minds before it all happens. And of course, there are more armed groups in Burma now than there were 6 months ago. So this problem is actually getting worse rather than better. So it's a good idea for people at the state level to be talking with each other about how to handle this within their particular state.
Okay. So ပေါ့เนาะဆိုတော့ဒီလိုမျိုးဒီတက်ဒီလိုကြတော့တက်ဆိုင်တဲ့ပြည်နယ်နဲ့တက်ဆိုင်ရဲ့ပြည်နယ်ရဲ့အနေထားပေါ်မှာအခြေခံပြီးတော့ state by state သူအနေနဲ့ဒီဒီကင်တွေတွားရင်တော့အကောင်းဆုံးဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတော့အလားတူပဲလက်ရှိမြန်မာနိုင်ငံရဲ့အနေထားမှာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်လုံခဲ့တဲ့6လထက်စာပြီးတော့ယနေ့အချိန်မှာပို့ပြီးတော့လက်နက်ကင်တက်ဒီအများကြီးထွက်ပေါ်လာတယ်တနည်းအားဖြင့်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒါအကောင
ဒီနေ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ဒီနေ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ဒေတာမှာဘယ်လိုမျိုးဒါကိုကျွန်တော်တို့အနေနဲ့အဲဒီတက်တွေနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့အဲနေရာချထားလဲဘယ်လိုမျိုးစပ်ပူးပေါင်းဆောင်ရွက်ဖို့အတွက်လုပ်မလဲဆိုတာကို
I think that generally covered a lot of the questions on the military, and we have a limited time, so I think we'll move forward. In going towards a federal state, do you think that it is necessary to combine all of the 7 Burman-dominated states into 1 Burman state?
Okay. Ami, do you want to translate?
Yes, Professor. Yeah. So the federalism federalism
Yes, Professor. So
this is a question that has been with us for a very long time, at least since 1947, and different people take different views. And as I mentioned a minute ago, it's always important to remember that we each have our own answer, but we might be wrong. And so I want to say that I respect people who disagree with me on this, but I do have a view, and that is it would be a very bad idea to combine the 7 quote unquote Burman states into 1 big Burman mega state.
So
Bad idea,
professor.
Now, I have several reasons for this. The first is this. I just went through the 6 benefits of federalism, and they all work better the closer you push power to the people. If we combine all 6 Burman states into 1 big state, that's a state that's almost as big as the nation as a whole, right? I mean, it's not that much smaller. And as a result, federalism won't work really well with a state that's that huge. We want to push power even more close, even closer than that.
So, federalism ဒီဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်ဇင်ရဲ့အကျိုးကျေးဇူးတွေချောက်ချက်ကိုကျွန်တော်အနေနဲ့တင်ပြပါရပါเนาะဆိုတော့အဲ့ဒါမျိုးကျွန်တော်ကဘာလို့ဒီပမာပြည်နယ်တိုင်းဒေသကြီးခုနှစ်ခုကိုပြည်နယ်တစ်ခုအနေနဲ့တူတာသွားမယ်ဆိုရင်အကြီးဖြစ်သွားမှာဆိုတော့အဲ့လိုအကြီးဖြစ်သွားတဲ့အခါမှာကြတော့သူကဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်ဇင်တုံးတော်ညာလဲပဲသူကသူ့ရဲ့စူပရမှုအနေထားရကသူကဒီစင်ထရယ်လစ်ဇင် ပုံစံမျိုးသူကသွားရောက်သွားနိုင်တယ်ပေါ့เนาะဒါကြောင့်မလို့ဒီလိုမျိုးတစ်ခုတည်းမှာအကြီးအဲ့လိုကြီးစုပြီးဖွဲ့လိုက်တာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီဒီလောက်ပိုင်ခွင့်အာဏာတွေကိုပြည်သူတွေနဲ့ဒီနေရာတို့မဟုတ်ဘဲနဲ့ဝေးရာတို့ရောမှာသူကပြန်ပြီးတော့လဲသွားစေမယ်သဘောရှိရပေါ့เนาะဒါကြောင့်မလို့ကျွန်တော်အနေနဲ့ကတော့လက်ဒီကတော့ဒီဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်ဇင်ရဲ့အကျိုးကျေးဇူးချက်ချက်တင်ပြသွားတဲ့အခါ
Now, here's the second reason. The different Burman divisions are actually really different from each other. Sagaing is really, really different from Yangon division. And they're going to have different values and different perceptions and so forth. So they will want to govern themselves in their own way. And here's the third reason that I think it's a bad idea. When people make this proposal, what they're often saying is this. The different ethnic states belong to the titular ethnic group. So Kachin state belongs to Kachin state, to Kachin people, and Shan state belongs to Shan people, and so forth. And then they say, well, in that case, the Burmans should have one state and only one state of their own. And as a result, we should pull all of those seven divisions into one big mega state. I think this is a very big mistake because the reality is all of Burma's states, all of Burma's divisions are multi-ethnic and multicultural. Now, we hope that by pushing power closer to the people, local cultural groups can govern themselves in their own way. But that doesn't mean that the Burmans somehow own central Burma. And it doesn't mean that the Shans own Shan state. All of the peoples of these various states and divisions have to live together. And this, of course, goes back to the minorities within minorities problem. So I think it's a mistake to view the world in this way, right? Those states in central Burma belong to everybody and not just the Burmans. Now, having said that, all I really mean to say is that I think it's a bad idea to combine the seven divisions. But that doesn't mean that we should refrain from moving the boundaries around. The boundaries, of course, were imposed by the Tatmadaw and imposed relatively recently. And so it may be that we need to move some of these boundaries at some point. But that's a really different thing from making this huge state in the middle of Burma. So Liz, I don't know whether we have time for one last quick question or not.
Yep, I think we have time for one more.
Okay.
So three or four different questions. The general gist of it was, in your opinion, which type of federalism suits Myanmar? They said that they've heard of lots of different types, such as ethnic-based federalism, geography-based federalism, asymmetric, symmetric. Okay. There's conversations about federal versus confederal systems.
Oh, yes, okay.
Do you think suits Myanmar best?
Good. Well, thank you very much. So so this is a question, of course, that now I need to talk for about four more hours to answer all of this because it's very complicated and technical. So let me just say two things. The first is Burma really can't borrow a model of federalism from any other country. Burma is truly unique, and we need to design a system of federalism that is right for Burma. And that's going to take a lot of time and a lot of focus. Now, I hope that's part of what we'll be doing in the next several lectures.
Okay. ဒီမေကိုနဲ့မှာဒီဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်စမ်မျိုးမျိုးရှိတယ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ဒီလူမျိုးစုကိုအခြေခံတဲ့ဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်စမ်ပြီးတော့ဒီပထဝီဝင်ဒေသအနေထားကိုအခြေခံတဲ့ဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်စမ်ပြီးတော့ခါအချိုးညီဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်စမ်ပြီးတော့ခါကျတော့အချိုးမညီဖက်ဒရယ်လစ်စမ်ပေါ့နော်ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီအနောက်ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ဒီမေးမြန်းသူတူဦးပြပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ခါကျတော့ဒီဖက်ဒရယ်မြန်မာနိုင်
But I will give a quick answer, and I can't elaborate as much as I would like, but I'll just give you the bottom line. So first, as between symmetrical and asymmetrical federalism, I think Burma really needs symmetrical federalism, and I'll talk about why that's true maybe in a future lecture. But I want to stress here, lots of people, I'm afraid, misunderstand. Excuse me, lots of people misunderstand the distinction between symmetrical and asymmetrical federalism. All symmetrical federalism means is that the states all have the same powers. But of course, they're going to do really, really different things with those powers. So there's going to be huge variation. So all it really means is that all states have equal rights of self-determination.
So,
Second, as between federal and confederal systems, the problem here is different people use these terms in really different ways. And so it's hard to give a definitive answer to them because the meanings are so different.
So the Madunia, the Anitari Shi, so the Achuni Federal Sine Aumashi, General the Binary, the Kujenzima, Throne, Throne Sustad, Jamia Boma, Moody, Lopan Quinia, Duanetu, at Tama Jat and the Gentle Doma Sidem.
I think what we can summarize though by saying is that in a confederal system, the states have more power than in a federal system. So remember that in a federal system, by definition, the states are guaranteed some powers, but in different federal systems, the states have more power than others. And so my answer on this continuum, is that in Burma, the state should have a lot of power. This should be a very deconcentrated kind of federalism, which, you know, might be called a confederalism, except again, that the terms don't have a lot of meaning.
Okay, so the name of the name of the solution the confederalism, for example, so I had already the look, the man again, my the Ginega, the gay away, look by winning Yaji Yatin and the Tama Shire. So they are Muga Elma confederalism bones and unit on the solution. The book where the Venus Dine Suyaga, Dunine, the look by quit Anago, JJ looks on with Yamme bones and Yuba.
Okay. As between ethnic and geographical federalism, I'm actually going to talk about this in the very next lecture because it's all going to be about how federalism can have self-determination.
So the Lumyosu chicken federalism Lumyosu chicken federalism federalism lame
But again, let me give a summary answer now just to, so I can provide some kind of clarity. Federalism, of course, by definition, tries to empower local cultural groups because it pushes power closer to people. And that means that certain ethnic groups are going to feel as though they have more power under federalism, more power to govern themselves in their own way. So in that sense, this is about ethnicity.
So the Lumyosu chicken federal syndicals and you would federal bones and synonym solution to look by quick anaha, diduri net and nigaso, diduri, candy, bureau, kajaro, dao, at the gentle bureau, a bidurine and nizo, my look by quick anash, yabono, sura kajaro, dine and nina, the two year biduri blue look as how you nina, blue, you need how much she needs as well, two in it and nigger.
Now, on the other hand, when some people use the phrase ethnic federalism, what they mean is that only certain ethnic groups actually are entitled to be citizens within particular states. So that only Chin people can be citizens in Chin state, only Bama people can be citizens in Yangon division. And that is absolutely not what I mean. I think this would be absolutely disastrous for Burma and deeply unjust. And I don't think it would be good for anybody in the long run. So if that's what you mean by ethnic federalism, no, definitely not.
So the Lumyosu chicken, the Federation, Lupiore, come up, not Kajan, General Mian Bajara, Palace or Kajaro, the Uma Chin Solution, Chin P. Nanganda. Ladube, a Yangon solution, Yangon yet Nanganda, Alumuvo, Daniels, who indicate Taya Imadama, I believe them be and the Epiomala, the Sowari and the Tao, some gentle maps, General Solura, Ramu Hobau.
Great, thank you so much. And I think we've run a little past the 2 hour mark. Thank you so much for staying here with us. I'm very much looking forward to the next one, where we're going to turn the focus a little bit. And instead of talking about how federalism is good for everybody, we're going to talk about how it can be used as a tool to address ethnic complaints and unhappiness to make peace for all the country.
That should answer a lot of the questions that we didn't get to today. So
all right, good, good. So your question was again. The next time.
Next time. Okay, right. So before we go, I just have a couple things to say in closing. As you all know, the public lectures on federalism were organized by the National Unity Government of Myanmar's Ministry of Education and the Burmese American Community Institute. We're especially grateful to His Excellency Dr. Zoe So, Deputy Minister Sayama Jatwepan, Eliza Vahni, and all of their teams at BACI and the NUG's Ministry of Education for all their hard work. We're also thankful to all of our partners and friends in Myanmar who continue to invite us to be a part of this conversation. In particular today, we're grateful to Ami, who served as our interpreter for today, but who is actually here in Bloomington with us, working to earn her doctoral degree in law and democracy at Indiana University. And finally, thank you to Professor Williams for your presentation today and for your wholehearted dedication to the people of Myanmar. Moving forward, we have two more public lectures that are scheduled. There might be more than that, they will be on August 7th and then on September 4th. And more information about these will be posted on the Facebook pages for BACI and the NUG's Ministry of Education. So thank you all, and see you at the next lecture.
Recording stopped.
Thank you very much, all. Thank you.